I'm here with Brendan Small, the creator of Metalocalypse, and we're here to talk about the Dune Star Requiem, which is a, I would call it a rock opera, but it's actually a clock opera. Am I correct?
It's a clock opera because the band in the show Metalocalypse is Death Clock.
Tell us about Metalocalypse and what it is.
Spinal Tap, this is the best movie, the best, most authentic musical movie, I think. We realized we couldn't do that story because there are a lot of great comedy stories that are doing that, a group of musicians who are kind of on their way out. So what if we were the biggest act on earth? What would that be like? My show is very different from what you do in one big way, which is that we don't have a budget for anything. So on my show, it basically, I'm limited to what I can do by myself in a room, which is guitars, programming drums. When I decided to do the Dune Star Requiem, that's when I said, okay, I don't know how many more opportunities like this I'm gonna have, and it's time to find a way to get more money so I can have the team that I want on this record.
There is a way you write for the orchestra samples that you have.
Yeah.
That to me has become a stylistic sound for the show.
Right.
And I remember there's so many orchestral cues, you know, there's some blocky brass chords,
yeah.
There's like big concert chime bells and timpani.
That's early on, yeah.
Exactly, but I don't want to lose that.
Right,
for better or worse, whether or not it's good orchestration to have the whole brass just be like, blaring into your brain. That's kind of become the sound for the orchestra in the show.
Yeah.
So I tried to like preserve that.
I mean, that's the whole thing about Metalocalypse is hopefully the creative process is this. I bring something to the table and somebody beats it.
When we recorded the orchestra on this, what was that experience like for you?
I remember my girlfriend was there. She told me, she pulled me aside, she goes, I kind of started getting emotional listening to your stuff getting played. And she goes, did you? And I go, to a degree. And then I remember how much money I was paying, so I wanted to make sure we got through all this stuff
at the same time. Tears were from a different reason.
Yeah, the tears were financial tears.
My wife, Rhea Yarbrough, who fans of mine know has sung on a bunch of my stuff, sings in a pivotal moment.
I wrote a melody that I really liked a lot, and she said, oh, I've got a few different takes on this. And I said, well, let's hear what you got. And
I have never heard my wife sing like that. It's something that I don't even think she knew she could do. I mean, that's what makes the whole rock opera so great, is that every song is a treat.
And that's why I couldn't do a death metal orchestra that's all metal, because I wouldn't want to do that. I don't think it would work, and I wouldn't want to listen to that, because it's going to be this dynamic the whole time. And you've got to have these peaks and valleys.
I got to say, this thing looks incredible, and it sounds incredible, and to finally have the chance for me to be able to come play around in this toy box, you know? It's been so much fun.
I had a lot of fun doing it, and it's my favorite things all wrapped together in one thing, which is I love telling story, and I love playing music, and I like to wrap it together, and that's fun for me. And that's how I grew up, was watching stupid rock operas, and I'm having a lot of fun. I really enjoy the project a lot, and it's a really great group of people. Bear, of course. You're gonna hear what he did.
Indeed you will.
And it comes out October 27th on Adult Swim. But more importantly, the record comes out the 29th. And I think it's gonna be something that's just gonna be fun to listen to.
I had these songs in my head for days.
For
days. And ultimately, I mean, the main reason I did it, I'm a fan of your show, but when I heard those songs, was I thought they're great songs, and I feel like you left me room to do something.
Yeah.
You know, and it was just great. So I'm just so stoked for people to hear it, and we should do it again. Brendan Small, everybody.
Hi.
Thanks.
I'm here. I mean, goodbye.
Goodbye.
See you later, folks. Thanks for watching. Be nice to your parents.